Hey everyone, today we are going to talk about UV mapping. Some of you may have came across this term before, but others may not have. So what is UV mapping? Well, UV mapping is the 3D modeling process of projecting a 2D image onto a 3D model surface for texture mapping. The term UV refers to the bidimensional or 2D nature of the process. U represents the x-axis of the 2D plane, while V represents the y-axis of the 2D plane. This is basically a form of translation. It translates 2D textures into 3D by this process. Have you ever heard about the term origami? The Japanese art of folding paper into decorative shapes? This process right here is similar to UV mapping, but reverse. In this process, you usually transform paper from a 2D plane into a 3D object. Well, the same can be applied to 3D models. Once you have completed modeling your object, you can then split it into various 2D sections. The splitting process is called UV unwrapping. In order to achieve this process, you have to apply seams to your object. Now you're probably wondering what seams are. Well, seams are basically lines that divide your 3D model into various sections. After you have finished UV unwrapping your model, you can now apply textures onto the 3D object from the 2D space. This is usually done in something called a UV editor. Most 3D applications have their own versions of the UV editor with similar tools across the board. For example, Maya has one, Cinema 4D, Houdini, 3ds Max, and so much other applications out there. But in this tutorial, we'll be using Blender, as you can see on my screen. Now I'm sure you have a basic understanding of what UV mapping is. So now let me take you through some practical examples of how this is done in the real world. First, we're going to UV unwrap a basic shape, like this cube, so you can have the fundamentals down. And then I'll do something a bit more advanced, so you can see how this works with even more difficult models. Okay, so here we have a cube. First, let me pull up the UV editor so you can see what happens while we UV unwrap this cube. So far, the cube looks perfectly unwrapped based on the diagram in the UV editor, but that is not the case. If you look carefully, you can see the 2D space does not correspond with the 3D space accurately, because this middle part here is supposed to be the bottom, but it is actually the right side of the cube. This part is supposed to be the left side, but it is actually the bottom. This part is supposed to be the right, but it is actually the top, and so forth. So how do we correct this? Well, we have to UV unwrap this from scratch, and you will see how to do it. So first, let's apply a UV grid texture to the object so you have a better visualization of the process. As you can see, the cube looks perfectly unwrapped here because the UV grid on the surface of the cube has perfect blocks or squares all around. This is one way to tell if your object is UV unwrapped properly. For example, if the squares are not even and they look elongated or stretched, this means you have not UV unwrapped your object correctly. And when you start to apply textures to your object, it is going to look distorted. So to avoid this, you have to make sure the model is UV unwrapped properly. And this can be done by applying proper seams to your object when UV unwrapping. So let's apply seams to the object. And when you are applying seams to your object, don't just apply seams randomly. Make sure you think this through, because bad seams can cause poor UV structure. For instance, you see for this cube, I placed the UVs in a way that is going to make the cube unfold into a shape that is easily readable, similar to origami. Remember in origami, when making a paper into a cube, the shape usually looks like this before forming the structure of the cube, and then the person would fold all these sides together to form this structure on the left. Well, for UV mapping, the process is quite similar as I said earlier. Also, when applying seams to sharp objects, make sure the seams are placed on the edges and try to place the seams where you think it is going to make the unfolding process easier to read. For example, let's say I subdivide this model. Now we have more edges and vertices on this model. It has much more details than before. And let's apply seams here and unwrap this. As you can see, the model looks very confusing. Now this part here corresponds with this part, and this part corresponds with this other part. If you were working in a game development team, and you send this to the texture artist, that person is going to get a hard time texturing this object, because it was unwrapped in a confusing manner, and seams are just placed at random instead of being carefully thought through. So that is why it is important to apply seams in areas that are going to unfold in a readable manner. This usually takes a lot of practice for persons who are doing this for the first time. But as you keep practicing, you're going to get better at this. Now let's move on to something a bit more advanced. Let's UV unwrap this cup. As you can see, this is a bit more complex than the cube we did earlier, because it has round edges and multiple parts. The hand is one part, and the body is another part. However, the principles of UV unwrapping are the same. Now let me apply the UV grid texture to this so you can see what it looks like before it is UV unwrapped. The UV grid texture is very important because it helps you have a better visualization of the structure of your UVs, and it helps you see which parts are UV mapped correctly. Now as you can see, the texture looks very distorted in a lot of places. The UV grids on the surface of the model need to be even or close to even for it to be acceptable. Now let's UV unwrap this to fix the problem we have here. Okay, so let's select the outer top area and the side of the cup body, both internal and external. Let's also select the inner top area and mark seam. Let's hide the handle for now. Now let's unwrap this and see what happens. As you can see, the body looks distorted. That's because we have not unwrapped this object properly. We need all the UV grids to line up properly with almost even proportions. So let's fix that. Let's select the bottom circumference and apply the seam. Now let's unwrap this again and see what happens. As you can see, the outer layer looks proportionate. So now let's do the internal part. Select the bottom and mark seam. Now let's unwrap this again. Now you can see the UV grid is distributed almost evenly across the surface of the model. Now let's pack islands to fit them properly in the UV space. Perfect. Now that we have finished this part, let's move on to the handle. Let's hide the main body and just focus on the handle. Let's select the back edges of the object first. Mark seam. Now let's select the right side of the object. Remember, we want to select areas that will make the UVs easily readable. Now let's mark seam. Good. Now let's do the left side and mark the seam. Good. Now let's unwrap this model and see what happens. As you can see, the UV grid looks elongated. That's because the scaling of the object is out of place. So how do we fix this? Let's apply all transforms to reset the scaling and then UV unwrap it again and see what happens. Good. Now you can see we have perfect grids across the surface of the model. So now that we have unwrapped this model, let's position the UVs in a readable manner. Okay, so this here is the left side. Let's move this one up. And this here is the right side. Let's move this one up and rotate it facing the opposite direction of the other. This one is the back side, and this one is the front area. Good. So now that we have completed this, let's bring back the body so we can see the perfectly unwrapped cup. Now that we have completed unwrapping the cup, let us now apply some real textures to the model so it can look more realistic. And you'll get to see how the real texturing process works. Okay, let's go into shading and select the body and then apply a new texture. We are going to call this texture Cup Body. Now let's select an image texture and apply it to the base color. Now let's select the body of this cup and assign a new texture to it. As you can see, the texture is perfectly aligned and no distortion can be seen. Now let's select the handle and apply a new texture. Let's call this wood and assign the wood texture to the handle. Let's apply a surface for the cup to rest on. As you can see, the cup is fully textured and all the details are accurately displayed both inside the cup and outside due to proper UV structure. Now let's say I do not UV unwrap this model or didn't unwrap it properly. This is what the texture would look like when applied. As you can see, the texture looks very distorted and the details of the texture look very inaccurate. That is why it is important to always UV unwrap your model properly, because if not, you will have issues when your texture is displayed on the surface of the model. Now let's remove the texture and look at the UV grid. As you can see, the squares on the UV grid are not aligned or proportionate at all. This is why it is important to apply a UV grid texture to your model when UV unwrapping, so you can get accurate feedback of how textures would be displayed. Now I hope this tutorial was very useful to you. In the next tutorial, I'll be talking about a little more advanced topic. That is going to be about texture size and texel density when dealing with UVs. Thank you for your time, and please subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell for more content, and stay tuned for more important information. Thank you.